I lived with a worm. People say it was my son, but I know better. I remember well. It was not that long ago. Now I live alone. Worm was pale and thin, so slender, with bulging eyes, and a mouth so wide. He was only 5. A peculiar creature, unable to be human. All those years I stared, bewildered at this odd thing. Was it love or hate? My worm son lies there, so peacefully in its bed. Large, still, and silent. I watch, I ponder, could not figure it out. How could it be mine? Every move it makes seems so very alien. Slow and slithering. It disgusted me. But I tried to bond with it. We went to the woods. It was excited. I had hoped it would get lost. Frozen and alone. Plays and I watch. It seems very innocent. I do not trust it. It somehow has friends. More little worms everywhere. I cannot stand them. Son is so cute, that's what I hear people say. I do not agree. It had no purpose, a noisy decoration, a tiresome, small worm. So exhausting, always wanting attention, pathetic whining. Then I had enough, a rope around the worm's neck. That'll do the trick. The worm is playing. Into the bedroom I crept. No more. Bye bye, worm. I was free at last. There was no worm in my home. I sigh. I relax. I must tidy up. I put worm in a suitcase to hide in the shed. What happened? I ask. It's gone away, I say. Living with grandma. don't feel guilty. In time, they'll all forget. Things will be normal. I feel so alive. I can be myself again. Worm make my skin crawl. Days, weeks, months had passed. I suddenly felt lonely. This had surprised me. I did not miss Worm. I wanted another pet, as I hate people. A large block of clay. I begin to work, molding my fingers, busy. I scrape and I squeeze, and a shape begins to form. Head, body, arms, legs. It's now finished, but I'm dissatisfied. My skills are lacking. So I try again. I'll create a clay friend for companionship. No, too misshapen. This one far too delicate. None are suitable. This one's better. It's still not quite what I want. It's too long in the leg. Soon I have many, all neatly placed upon a shelf, always watching me. There's one clay boy. He looks a little like Worm. With shining eyes. So captivating. The creature I should have had. Perfect creation. The others hate him. I can hear them all whisper, get rid of the worm. Louder and louder. I do not know what to do. I feel tormented. Everywhere. The clay hands claw at my brain. I cannot escape. I smash the clay worm and I hasten to the shed. and take the suitcase. I drive to the sea. The suitcase is swept away. Both worms are now dead. Sits, their gaze holding me captive. They want me to kill. Day and night. I fear I'm mad. I lock myself in. The clay army gets closer. Try to hide. I'm the leader. Do not listen to me. I sit and panic. Room and wonder what I have done. Is worm haunting me? Break free and run. Smash them all to pieces. All around me. Breathless, I slump down. On the floor, I see fresh clay, glistening. Try once more to make myself a clay friend. This time it will work. I toil through the night, frantic. Desperate fingers. Clay friend taking shape. Stuck in a cycle, making clay people. So many long days. I am stuck in a cycle, making clay people. I focus on one. It gets taller, intricate. The figure is me. I wrap some around. I cocoon myself in clay. My protective shell. I feel safe in here. Sheltered in my clay haven. No worms. No anguish. So here I shall stay. Be at one with my clay self. Until I perish.